Hello. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back after lunch. Again, we are gathered here to the plumbing only. One of the key part of the plumbing is treatment. I will be covering two lectures. One is sewage treatment plant and another is water treatment plant. So now it is sewage treatment plant. Last time when I covered sewerage, what is the meaning of sewerage? Anybody answer please. What should the sewerage consist of?
Soil and waste.
So, black and grey water. Now there is a trend upcoming black water should be treated separately and grey water should be treated separately. However, the country like us cannot have that luxury of treating it separately. But if you look at Middle Eastern countries, they treat it separate most of the time. Black water and grey water, because they don't mix it. They don't like to use the flush water in the even for the flushings. So let us start. What is the objective? If I have to simply define, see presentations are there, you will get it. Try to understand the science behind it, which I will tell you now. Why treatment? What is the objective of sewage treatment? So, when we talk about circular economy, getting the things from nature, giving it to back to nature, again getting it from him. So, when we get the water from nature, what we do? We pollute it, we contaminate it by using it, And when we have to give it to back to nature, then we must treat it. If we just return the untreated water, we can see the problems all around. So, whenever we are returning it to the nature, it has to be environmental friendly. We cannot just give a toxic water which will impact the aquatic life, Or we cannot give the colorful water which is changing the shade of color. We cannot give the water with maximum content of phosphorus and nitrogen, which accelerates the aquatic life, which helps the biology in the river to outgrow, which is incorrect. The vegetation has to grow naturally. But if you put more nutrients to it, what will happen? It will grow faster, which is incorrect. So it has to be, whatever you are throwing back, it has to be sustainable, it has to be natural friendly. Also, reuse the treated water for non-potable purposes like flushing, irrigation and cooling towers. There are many more uses. This is a very important statement. Water, air is not inherited from our parents. We have borrowed them from our grandchildren. You must be knowing all the organization, institutes running behind the COP. Now recently COP28 has conducted in the Dubai. So what is that? The program to lower the temperatures, to they are encouraging the usage, the reusing of the things, treating the waste and all. So what are the characteristics of sewage? So we should know what we need to treat. Without knowing what we need to treat, we cannot treat. What are the parameters? There are hundreds of parameters defined in the IS code for a good drinking quality water. But when you use it and you have to throw it, there are certain parameters which are focused by many of the committees. Either it is Maharashtra Pollution Control Board, or environmental clearance committees, or various other organizations, NGOs. They focus on these five parameters: pH, BOD, COD, dissolved solid, suspended solid, oil and grease. So, throughout the life cycle of your academy or professional career, you will come across for these 5 to 6 parameters only. They are very well defined in IS codes. What is the acceptable limit for consumption? and what is the acceptable limit for disposal? What is BOD? BOD is a biological oxygen demand. Whatever biologies are present in the water, what is their demand? At 0 day, at 5 days. So usually it is denoted as BOD at 5 days. Then COD, chemical oxygen demand. So whatever chemicals available in the chemicals present in the sea waste, they also need certain amount of oxygen. So culture is developed in the laboratories, and after 4 to 5 days, it is identified how much oxygen they are consuming based on their intensity, quality, their type parameters are identified for the chemicals or biology. Then type of sewage treatment. So broader, see these charts are there available in the PPTs. This is a, as I am expert, I will summarize the subject for you. There are three parts: collection, treatment, storage. In storage, there are three parts: equalization, treatment, digestion, filtration. Okay, simple three parts: equalization, digestion of the sewage, and filtration. Filtration is a very important aspect of any treatment, either it is water or sewage. So there are various treatment processes available: activated sludge process, ASP, FBR, FBBR, SBR, MBR. Kunal gave presentation about MBBR, advanced MBBR. There is FAB, there is SAF, extended aeration, there are phytoreed, there are reed bed. There are n number of technologies are available in the sewage treatment. So first is screening, grit chamber, primary settling, one part as I said. Second part, biological treatment, that is digestion, digestion by the bacteria, and then filters, it comes filter, and then stabilization, dewatering, and uses for the different requirements like agriculture and disposal. Treatment stages: primary, secondary, tertiary. You can again put the summary which I gave you: equalization, digestion, and filtration into this. So primary is what? Equalization. Whatever sewage comes, store it for 2 to 4 hours. Once you store it, it will automatically try to neutralize the pH of the sewage. There is a soap, there is oil, there are many detergents, many things. So what happens? Some part in the sewage is acidic, some part is alkaline. But if you have to get it digested through bacteria, can any human being, can any living being survive either in alkaline or in acidic nature? Very difficult. And particularly the bacteria which require to digest the sewage cannot live on the acidic or alkaline for type solution. They can perform well only if the sewage is neutral. So primary treatment consists of screening, collection, and equalization. Bath screen chamber, segregation, plastic, rats, rocks, napkins, and floating objects. So there are various bath screens. There are nowadays mechanical screens are also available. Okay. Here the presentation is made to give you the broader understanding. It is your duty to get deeply involved, deeply dived into the particular thing and identify what things are available nowadays. Settle and segregate smaller particles like sand and manually collected salt away. So what a grit chamber will do? It will, whatever suspended particles are there, it will try to settle and flow can go on. Then there is a oil and grease trap. Simple oil and grease trap will remove the oil and grease. If the excess content of oil and grease is there, I am saying excess, there is certain portion of oil and grease can be treated, digested by the bacteria in secondary treatment. But if the content of oil and grease is more excessive, then they cannot die. In fact, the bacteria will die. So, oil and grease separation is required. Whenever you are designing a commercial property with particular kitchen for the employees, you must provide the oil and grease. Equalization tank, as I said, equalization will have a storage of the sewage for certain amount of time, like 2 to 3 hours, 4 hours. It will neutralize the pH. Also, it will emulsify the sewage. Whatever sewage has come, either it is from soil, waste, kitchen, anywhere, it will try to emulsify automatically. You don't need to put anything separate. Then, secondary treatment. So, purely biological, oxygen transfer, converting dissolved organics to settleable biological solids. There are two types of processes. One is anaerobic, one is aerobic. Now, anybody from you, what is anaerobic? With example. Aerobic with example. Septic tank. Does septic tank require whatever bacteria are there in the septic tank? Do they require oxygen? Do they require oxygen? No. Septic tanks are now ruled out. That's why you might know that. But septic tank is a inbuilt process where bacteria does not consume oxygen and treats the sewage. But they don't make the sewage again reusable. You need to have the filtration. So here we are going to look at the process which consumes the bacteria consumes the oxygen. Okay, and then they treat. So aerobic, anaerobic. Purely biological, oxygen transfer, converting dissolved solids into settleable biological solids so that whatever sludge is there, that get digested and settled, and you transfer the good quality water into another storage tank. So aerobic treatment, sewage, oxygen, microorganism, respiration, water, gases, energy, synthesis, more microorganism. Treatment schemes. Now here we start different type of treatment schemes. Technologies, we can say. ASP, activated sludge process with extended aeration. So extended aeration is one process, ASP is one process, both are combined and made ASP. Now this is, we can say, early era technology or old technology. So as I said, you need, I will tell you the crux of matters. So everything lies in this secondary treatment. Only digestion is a criteria, a very important criteria, and type of digestion has evolved. Earlier, they used to need a lot of areas for the digestion of the sewage and then creating a good quality water. Nowadays, with SAF, MBBR, small area is required for the culture to grow and treat the water. So, you have to focus here. After equalization, aeration tank. So aeration is important for the bacteria because these bacteria consumes oxygen, right? Then clarifier, which filters out the water and sludge separate, and then sludge is again sent to filter press. Cakes are done that can be used as a manure, good manure, quality manure. Then clarification, pressure sand filter, activated carbon filter. Now there is a third one, multigrade filter, which serves the purpose of both these filters. Okay, and then some doser, either it is chlorine or ozonation. Okay, and then final collection tank is created. Water is sent to final collection tank. So ASP with extended aeration. Clarified water contains residual biological matter need to be filtered before discharge. Disinfection is mandatory. This is disinfection. Whatever residual chlorine you are going to leave in the water, which will be there till the usage, so that because of chlorine, if there are any bacteria, they will get killed. Okay? Again, try to understand one important aspect here. Filtration is important. Removal of bacteria is important. You cannot let the bacteria to be there if you want to make this water drinkable after certain more processes. Okay? There are certain type of bacteria which die, but they again live if they come into contact with certain chemicals. So removal is very important. That's why UV is a little failure. What does UV do? It kills. But then again you have to filter. Without filtration, your treatment process is incomplete. This is the parameter limits for the HTP design. pH, it has to be neutral. VOD less than 10 mg, COD less than 50 mg. TSS, total suspended solid. Then nitrogen, in total, less than 5. Fecal coliform, 100 mpn. Technically, coliform has to be absent. Technically, coliform has to be absent. Coliform is a very weak, very dangerous. Then residual chlorine, 1 mg per liter. If more, then problematic. Stomach sore, eye sore, it is dangerous. Now somebody may say, MOEF is asking for even less parameters. It is the independent organization, they can ask the relevant things. Okay, which are important for the society. This is as per ISPO. ASP with extended aeration limitation. MLSS values, 3000 to 4500. There are certain processes which are 10 times stronger. So MLSS, mixed liquor suspended solid value, go up to 35,000. Okay, then there is again one more criteria, MLVSS, mixed liquor volatile suspended solids. So that would become too technical here. Sludge carryover in the treated water. So it is not a 100% foolproof system. There can be some sludge will get carried forward in the treated. Colloidal particle, poor HDI. Density ratio, this is basically a sewage density index. So poor, it is poor. If it is good, then the treated quality water is also good. Difficult to maintain consistent treated water quality because the bacteria die, grow, treat, because the bacteria born, they digest sewage, they die, again new bacteria is born. This is not a very efficient system. Upsetting the system due to intake variation. So, for example, there is a festival. People are washing their homes. Detergent is more. So, that load cannot be taken. If people, again, festival season is there, oil and grease usage because of the frying activities. The oil spillage is more. Then that cannot be handled. Large area and huge civil work is required. As I said, this is a very early era technology. Large areas are required. FACT, FBBR, fluidized bed bioreactor. So same, process is same. You need to see only after equalization. What is there? Aeration, FBBR, aeration, FBBR. So there are beds, plastic beds are there. On that plastic bed, bacteria are allowed to grow and the water is trickled from that sheets, and that bacteria digested that sewage water and throws out the clear water. Remaining process remains same. See, here is also secondary clarifier which removes the sludge, then treated water, storage tank, filters, carbon filter. Okay. Yes, carbon filter. What is the use of carbon filter? To remove the carbon filter. Yes, Ajay. Odor, color. Carbon filter removes odor and color. TDS is again separate criteria, but your sand filter can be can remove the TDS up to certain extent, not up to the good quality extent, but yes, certain. FBBR media. So this is the media. ASP versus FBBR. So reduction in civil work, because FBBR is a little more advanced area technology. Area is required. Reduction in civil work is less. Smaller footprints for the media, two-stage biodigestion, better removal efficiency, lesser sludge generation. Because digestion is more, sludge is less. Limitation of FBBR relies on media surface. So these are the surfaces on which biology is stick, and then they digest. Sludge removal is by settling the secondary clarifier. Disinfection is mandatory for treated sewage. Final filtration is by sand filter. So wherever these conventional technologies are there, which are consuming, which are with biology and all, you have to have the filtration is must, and putting disinfection is also must. Then SBR. Again, technology is same. You can see this part after equalization. This part is changed. Nothing changes. Nothing changes. Only this part is changes. This is some scientists have made the experimentation and they have found the right way to implement. SBR advantages. So what would be the advantage? Further better than earlier technology, less area, more better efficiency. Okay, better quality treated water. So operation cycle of SBR. Influent, reaction, settle, decant, idle. 33% duration is allocated for this, 33 for this, 16 for this, total is 100%. What is the what is the requirement, object of the sequence, and air requirement. Then advantage, as I said, time controlled operation, no sludge recirculation, perfect quiescent settle, optimum energy efficiency, state of the art control, biological nutrient removal. Now MBR. Now coming to MBR, MBR is a process, membrane bioreactor. So it is defined as membrane only. Whatever membranes are there, they will filter out the water and we will give you a good quality water. All the game is about filtration. Even in earlier technologies, only the feed to the filtration is made in such a way that filters are not get impacted. So filters are manufactured of PVDF or HDPE material. What will happen if there are certain phosphorus and nitrogen amount is available in the sewage, which is there, they damages the filter. They damages the media. That's why anoxification, which removes the phosphorus and nitrogen, is important. Now, the one people who are working in a consultancy and attended the MOF meeting say the committee is asking to put anoxic tank for every treatment process. Yes. Why? Because nitrogen and phosphorus are nutrients and they help for the accelerated growth of the bacteria. That's why they to remove reduce that levels of P and L, the committee is asking to put the anoxification. So now, as I was always saying, here the thing is changed. Here it is MBR and then it goes to that immediately permeate tank. You don't need to put any filter. Why? MBR itself is a filter. Okay? And parameters of the MBR are also best. There is a comparative chart next. MBR concept, common steps, screening, biological aeration, MBR reactor, eliminate secondary. So secondary, whatever we were discussing here, I was continuously telling you this part, it is removed, not required. Why? I don't want to digest the sewage. I will just put a nice filter, best of the best quality filter, which will remove the undesired things and will give me the good quality water. So I am removing this as well as this by putting MBR. However, there are certain pros and cons that also we will see next. Now MVRs are backwashable, so good for the system. There are two types of MVRs, atmosphere to membrane and atmosphere within the membrane. So certain membranes, there are membranes is what? They are the filter tubes and they have porosity. So water either goes inside the tube and comes out from the porous part and filtration is done, or there is a chamber where the water is pressurized and they get inside through the porous and come out from the tube. Okay, it is based on everyone's, there are many manufacturers, it is based on the manufacturer. Poco, Norit, Zivit 500, G, you know, multiple attributes. So biological treatment and membrane bioreactor. See, this is how the tubes looks like and they are porous. So water goes inside and come out. Side stream MVR. So there are different type based on the installation. If you have a good size, you can go for Zivit, which is G. Then there are certain horizontal type of medias are also there. Okay, small cylinders are there in which the media is installed. You can just bring it, connect it to the STP and it will start functioning. So you can say this type of installation is there. Fiber construction. So this is fiber. There are three layer, various different fibers are there. Two layer, three layer, four layer. I have seen up to four layer. Two layer of membrane layers and one inner support layer so that it should not get damaged. So as I said, fiber properties, PVDF material, hydrophilic, high chlorine tolerant and tensile strength. This is required. We are going to put the pipe, water with pressure, it is sewage, it will have everything which is toxic. So membrane has to withstand everything. Submerged model installation technique. So this is how the installation is done. Treated water comparison, you can see this. This is, let us say, sewage. This is with the biodization, which I was continuously telling you, secondary treatment. This is with ultrafiltration. Most of the first world country drinks the treated water. Advantages, safe rejection biomass, enhanced standard of hygiene, BOD level 3 to 7 PM, PPM, ultrafiltration, water-free pathogens, sludge density index less than 3. Achieved consistently. This is important. Earlier what we saw, consistency was not there with AHP. Why? Because it cannot take the load of shock loads. Maybe festival, maybe vacation, but MVR is independent of that. Process superiority. It can tolerate large input variations, as I just discussed, aeration tank MLSS level, plus can be wasted directly to sludge handling equipment. Low SDI in treated water, sewage density index, modular unit facility, eliminates filters, no backwash is required, removes difficult pre-treatment for downstream, and disinfection only based on specific requirement. As you are already filtering the bacteria up to the desired level, you technically don't need, because if you are filtered it out, there is no bacteria. There are only allowable bacteria which will not harm you. But non-allowable bacteria are already removed. So you don't need any chlorination or ozonization. These are the charts. I mean, BOD level, TSS, COD and turbidity. What can be best achieved with this? But trust, listen carefully. This is with filtration, not only with the secondary treatment. Comparison of the technology. So you can just go through this for the academic purpose. Bar screen required, not required, oil grease, equalization, anoxic, aeration, settling, pre-filtration, sludge holding tank and plant. function performance attributes of the variables. Reliability, yes, of course, as technology evolved year by year, you will get the best of best results. Quality of treated water, of course, excellent. Process kinetics, well established. So you can see so many installations. Space required, certainly MBR requires least space among all of them. And ASP with extended aeration or extended aeration requires maximum space. Efficiency, of course, best. Sophistication of operation, high. What is the meaning of this? For all these STPs, you will require at least 3 to 2 operators who are continuously monitoring. Yes, please?
Skilled manpower.
Skilled manpower, yes. So you require manpower. Here, it is a highly automated plant. So you require one person who will monitor everything on a panel. If there is a problem, he will go and attend that. Manpower required to operate, not specific skill required, because they have to either have some chemicals, which is already defined by the operator. Here, high skill is required. He need to watch the panel. He need to understand what is the meaning of red light, green light, blue light, various lights, parameters, graphs, various meters. So he has to be qualified. Quality of the water required for HVAC. So next part is HVAC requirement. The only thing required for HVAC which STP doesn't do is softening. Water is hard. It is not up to the permissible limit. So the parameters are defined here. Makeup water for the STP, condenser water and chilled water. This is actually a nice table because you will see so many requirements in only one table here. Okay. So these are the prerequisites for the quality of the required for quality water required for the HVAC. So please ask any questions. I will add something natural technology, which is phytoread and reed based. One is developed by the NIRI, one is developed by the railway, DRDO. Okay. So whenever there are remote areas, because you know DRDO is a research based organization and they work for the army, and NIRI is a very strong organization which works in this particular expertise. So what do? They do many things. But DRDO and NIRI independently have evolved two technologies, reed beds and phytos. What do? They are advocating that certain species of vegetation are grown on the land and sewage is thrown on that. Okay, and then that sewage gets digested through these plants. Okay, now can anybody tell me whether it will be more efficient or less efficient than what we just discussed? Correct. You have to have a very large area compared to this biodigestion. That is first thing. Second thing, I mentioned one very critical statement. That is, you have to spray the sewage on the land where that vegetation is there. So what will happen? It's a dirty business. Mowing the sewage is a dirty business. You will have that drip irrigation network will be there, that will carry, you will force the sewage to go through that, that will spread. But again, it's not a very sophisticated mechanism. They have developed that from the mindset, at least use something rather than using nothing at the remote places. Some plants are running very good, not all. Okay. So these technologies technology also exists, and you can explore them more. Nowadays, in future, probably the world is talking about sustainability, zero liquid discharge, carbon credits, and whatnot. These processes may get excitement and glamour, and you will see more and more developers, the government is adopting read-based and phyto-read compared to all these ASP, this MBR, MBBR, and whatnot. Okay? Any questions?
Done.
No more questions?
Very illiterate audience.
Thank you, Amit. Again, a good technical presentation from STP. Next product presentation is from Aquatrain. I request Aquatrain to come forward. Yes, please join us.